It's Monday, January 7. This is the news on PBCJ. I am Simone Absalom. The Agriculture Ministry says there's a very high risk of increased beet armyworm in Junction and Southfield in St. Elizabeth. Farmers in these areas are being strongly advised to increase field monitoring to at least twice per week, looking for egg sacs and young worms. It says information on scallion fields in those areas indicate the likelihood of outbreak of beet armyworm if immediate action is not taken. Farmers are being urged to ensure good field sanitation, to handpick worms where practical, and promptly harvest mature scallion. In addition, farmers are being asked to look out for unmanaged and abandoned fields as they encourage more pests. The National Water Commission says some of its systems have been affected by drought conditions. The NWC says production has declined by 50% at facilities in St. James and Hanover due to the decline in rainfall. The affected facilities are Dantrode in St. James and New Milns in Hanover. They supply various communities. A news release from the Water Commission says customers will experience intermittent water supply, low water pressure, or no water. The Ministry of Local Government and Community Development and the National Housing Trust have signed a Memorandum of Understanding for the upgrade and expansion of the island's infirmaries. According to the Minister of Local Government and Community Development, Desmond McKenzie, the document was signed on January 3 at the ministry, signaling the government's continued push to increase the social protection programs for the poor and vulnerable. He pointed out that the NHD has provided about $220 million to upgrade and build facilities at infirmaries across the country. The minister said improvement of the island's infirmaries will also help to stem the problem of homeless persons seeking refuge at hospitals despite being discharged. McKenzie was speaking at a ceremony on January 4 to officially hand over a self-contained studio unit in Limehall, St. Anne, to an elderly man who was living in less than ideal conditions. The opposition's spokesman on health, Dr. Dayton Campbell, says not enough is being said about the seriousness of the recent dengue outbreak. Dr. Campbell is also of the view that Health Minister Dr. Christopher Tufton was derelict in his duties for failing to heed early warnings in 2018 that the country was likely to face a dengue outbreak. He was responding to a ministry's announcement last Thursday that there is now an outbreak of dengue fever in the island. Dr. Campbell, in a release Friday, said that in 2017, there were 177 suspected cases in the country. He said this worsened by December 14, 2018, when there were 560 reported cases, but that, despite the significant increase in cases of dengue, the health minister had continued to deny that there was an outbreak of the mosquito-borne disease in Jamaica. He said the underestimation and failure to mobilize the health system in a proactive manner had resulted in severe under-resourcing. In addition, he said a lack of early public education had led to persons taking drugs which were contradicting to dengue due to the increased risk of bleeding and subsequent development of dengue hemorrhagic fever and dengue shock syndrome, both of which may be life-threatening. In regional news, Venezuela's President Nicolas Maduro defended his government's legitimacy Sunday as his bid for a second six-year term has come under growing fire internationally by the country's opposition-controlled National Assembly. In another sign of turmoil around Maduro, who is to be sworn in Thursday, the Venezuelan Supreme Court confirmed that a justice who sat on a panel that deals with electoral issues has fled the country. News of the defection of Christian Zerpa came a day after the opposition-controlled National Assembly declared Maduro's presidency to be illegitimate and called for a transitional government to organize democratic elections. Responding on Twitter, Maduro declared, quote, "Legitimacy has been given to us by the people with their vote. To those who hope to break or will, make no mistake, Venezuela will be respected." End quote. Maduro was re-elected May 20 in a presidential elections called by a regime-backed constituent assembly and boycotted by the opposition, many of whose best-known leaders were under house arrest or barred from running. In sports, former national wicketkeeper Andre Coley says he's not averse to applying for the Jamaica Scorpions coaching job at the end of this first-class cricket season. The 44-year-old former West Indies senior team assistant coach is three-quarters away through his current two-year contract as head coach of Windward Islands Volcanoes. Coley told the Jamaica Observer, quote, "I still have 6 months on my contract with the Windwards, which will be done in June. Any kind of decision like that will be something I would have to discuss with my family," end quote. The 2018-2019 regional first class season is scheduled to close in March. Courtney Francis, the Scorpions' chief executive officer, has already said the franchise will be seeking someone for the permanent role when the contract period for interim head coach Robert Haynes expires at the end of April. And that's the news on PBCJ. Pleasant viewing.